There's a lot of cards out there that need an upgrade desperately. Let's see the best ones. What's good, everybody? What's going on? It's your boy Rob, aka Roboto. So in the video today, we're going to take a look at cards or player items that need an upgrade desperately. I'm talking about guys who haven't gotten an upgrade in weeks, if not months, if not all year. We'll dive into the whole list because it's Tuesday. We have no content to speak of, but it's okay. We can still make our own stuff here with Madden Ultimate Team. So before we jump into all that, I just want to let you know, if you are new here, I appreciate you for stopping by. We are so close to 5,000 subs. I can taste it. I can see it. It's right there. So show you love. Hit the sub. Would appreciate all support on this journey. Appreciate everybody, as always, for checking me out. Also, if you like this video, like this idea, like everything we're talking about, there's a player in here that you think definitely deserves an upgrade. Thumbs up on the video. And in the comment section down below, let me know which player do you think should get an upgrade next in Madden 21 Ultimate Team. Let's get into it. So basically what I went ahead and did is I went to Mutt.gg here. Shouts to Mutt.gg, shouts to Rockets and the whole team. I went here and I just basically kind of went through and picked guys based on different criterias. Now, the one main criteria on everything is nobody over a 93. And the reason why I picked the 93 is because I was finding a lot of 93s did need upgrades. Odell Beckham Jr., Kenyon Drake, for example. But I think it has to do with that kind of zero chill promo area range. So I kind of cut it off right at a 93. I know one of my guys will get a benefit of that on this list, but still, I cut it off right at a 93. I feel that's a little fair. That's probably around December range that we're going to cut that off. So around those guys, 92s and below only. If your last card is a 92, you're on this list for the most part and you have a big name. So keep that in mind there as well. Also, no special teams. One other thing to note too about this list, I'm going strictly current day dudes for this list only. We will jump into legends in a future video, but current day dudes is going to highlight this list. Obviously, you're watching this a little bit later on when this video comes out. Some names might be getting an upgrade and it might come out after this video comes out. So that's a good thing. We want to see new names here. And one final thing to note on this, I don't know when the programs are for these dudes, when they're going to get an upgrade. I don't know how they're going to get an upgrade, but you got to remember there's still a few more promos to come out. There's still, in particular, a potential power of expansion, There's also a potential space program. We still got about 2 or 3 months here of Mutt to go before we get the new game. So there's still some opportunity, but the clock is definitely ticking. And also, they were picked based on different things. Card need, had a good season, or even just need a theme team upgrade at that position. So there's a couple that I will talk about in particular, so let's get into it. And we're going to start right here on offensive line, and we're going to start with a big name offensive line, I'd say, is Taylor Lewan here. Arguably one of the more popular offensive linemen in the NFL. He's a big name, and his best card is an 87. I know he was hurt this year. He only played one game, I think, and his best card was a scary sharp 87 overall left tackle card, but he does have a power up, right? A 68 overall power up here. And I'm surprised he hasn't gotten any cards throughout the year at all. Not even a team builder upgrade, nothing. So 87 overall, Taylor Lewan here. I wonder why that is. There might be something going on there why he's not considered. But after him, we're going to jump into the running backs. And I want to start off here with the rushing list. Now, you can go through and check all these guys out, compare their stats and whatnot. But a lot of these guys have good cards, right? 93s, 94s, 95s and above. So I went ahead and I tried to dive in a little bit deeper beyond the surface here for a lot of these guys. And I went and talked about some guys in particular that either were hurt or might have shared a backfield, right? So the one I want to jump into first is obviously Saquon Barkley. I mean, it's my guy, it's my bro. This is a Giants theme team that's close to my heart here, but I do think Barkley needs an upgrade. His best card right now is a 92. Arguably one of the biggest names in the NFL, regardless of position. So I'm surprised he doesn't have any sort of upgrade, not even Easter promo, draft promo, nothing yet. So maybe as I'm saying this, something's going to come out and they're going to give him an upgrade. But Barkley right here, definitely in need of an upgrade. So overall, Barkley, I really like him. Obviously, he's one of the best players in the league when he's healthy, and he's going to be a great Mutt card when he gets an upgrade. Another guy that was hurt this year that didn't get much playing time is Marlon Mack. Now, he doesn't have a power up, so it's not as sexy of a name, but he didn't have a strong season this year at all because he really kind of didn't play. So Marlon Mack here, only one game played for him, so it's kind of tough to see you know, if he does or doesn't deserve it, but I think he's definitely in need of an upgrade more than anything. At 89, another guy who's kind of a Mutt favorite, kind of an NFL favorite, Tariq Cohen. I was shocked to learn, unless I'm wrong, this is Tariq Cohen's best card is a core gold. Tariq Cohen's a fun running back to use in mud. He's a fun running back in general. He's one of the more popular running backs in the NFL. He's always fun to watch out there for the Bears. Obviously, he was hurt this year, so not much to give an upgrade for team of the week wise, even end of the year awards. But I'm surprised he only has a gold, man. I could have definitely seen Tariq Cohen go somewhere in a draft promo in some way, shape, or form. Give him an upgrade because he is a speedy running back. People like to use him a lot, especially Bears themed teams, obviously. So another option here I'm going to go with, and it's kind of a split backfield scenario here. It's J.K. Dobbins and Gus Edwards from the Baltimore Ravens. You can pick either one. Doesn't really matter to me, but the way I'm seeing it here is that all these other guys got pretty much got upgrades above 90s here, and J.K. Dobbins and Gus Edwards are both under 90. Dobbins in particular is at 88. Team of the Week card is his best card there. He had a huge game, 160 yards, two tutties, and what was that, week 17. But Gus Edwards hasn't been touched at all this year. And he, you know, he's only 100 and some less, 125. 102 less yards rushing than J.K. Dobbins this year with more rushing attempts. So I don't know. Maybe Gus Edwards was running back one this year for the Ravens. So something to keep in mind there for the Ravens, Gus Edwards and J.K. Dobbins. Now we're going to jump over to the receivers, probably the sexiest position in all of Mutt. There's a lot of big names here. A lot of guys got upgrades recently. Diggs, Hopkins, Adams, Waller here, tight ends, Kelsey there, tight ends. Those guys are both above 95. Allen Robinson, Lockett, Allen Schuster. You guys know the names already. But there are some names that do deserve an upgrade. And one name you see right here on the list is Cooper Kupp. Just under a hair 1,000 receiving yards this year. But Cooper Kupp, man, had only a 92 here. It's his best card, unless there's another card I'm missing. But Cooper Kupp's best card here is a 92 with 89 speed on it. Now, when this LTD came out, it wasn't the sexiest, but route runner archetype is fun. So boost him up maybe to 97, 98. I mean, he was arguably the Rams' best receiver this year. He's top 25 in the league in receptions. Him and Robert Woods are up there. So Robert Woods got an upgrade not too long ago. We could see one for Cooper Kupp. Another guy here that's on the receiving yards list, and it's not in the top set here, but he is on the next page if you just flip over, is Adam Thielen. There's another guy there. You see Marvin Jones, but Adam Thielen's best card right now is a 90. I mean, he's not a huge name, popular name, but he's been consistently one of the best wide receivers in the NFL over the last few years. So I'm surprised he only has a 90, you know, just a 90, not even a 95, 96, nothing. So shouts to Adam Thielen there. Another guy you saw on that list there too was Marvin Jones Jr. Now, again, another guy's not the sexiest name, not the biggest and brightest name, but there are a couple good caveats here for Marvin Jones Jr. In particular, he just signed with the Jaguars in the offseason. So could that be potential movers program where we get an upgrade for Marvin Jones and some other dudes we'll touch on later on? Maybe. But right now, Marvin Jones' best card's a 92 with a 91 speed, I mean, 91 catch. So he could get an upgrade for sure. Another dude you could probably see in the movers of some sort, if there is one, Corey Davis here. Now, he just joined the Jets, I believe, in the offseason. And with that new deal, he's going to be signed with the Jets for a little bit. So why not give the Jets fans a little taste of their new big receiver here? Corey Davis at a 90 overall, but it's really interesting because he's 6'3", 210. He has some size on him. So it'd be very interesting if he does get an upgrade. I'd be happy to see it. He's definitely well-deserved there for the Jets and their new theme team or wide receiver. Now, a couple guys here who did perform pretty well this year and just, you know, maybe just needed an upgrade. One in particular is Nelson Agholor here. 84 is his best card right here. Now, I know everybody's going to joke about the drops in X, Y, and Z, but yeah, it's sort of a bounce back year here for the Oakland Raiders. So a little bit of a bounce back there for Agholor. Does he need a 99 overall? No, but, you know, an upgrade from an 84 probably would help him out a little bit there. Another solid receiver had a good year. T. Higgins, obviously, his production went down a little bit once Joe Burrow hit the sidelines. But T. Higgins had a breakout year as the rookie season. Be on the lookout for him, especially partnered up back there with Burrow and the other talent they got in the draft. So T. Higgins, a name to keep an eye out for, especially at 6'4 there. Pretty interesting. Physical archetype hurts him, but 6'4, I like the speed or the size, excuse me. But speaking of little speedy guys here, Cole Beasley, potentially, I could see a definite upgrade for him for sure. I mean, he was named to the All-Pro team, second team, granted, but still, All-Pro team nonetheless. There's a lot of receivers who would love to be on that All-Pro team. So Cole Beasley, I think he definitely deserves an upgrade, and 92 overall is his highest card. Get him up to 96, 97, maybe, if you want to be nice to him there. Beasley, definitely in need of an upgrade. Now, to stay in pass catchers, we're going to touch on a few guys that I think are in need of an upgrade for sure, and we're going to stick with the tight ends. In particular, one dude here who wasn't hurt this year is Kyle Rudolph. Now, I know, again, my Giants homer fandom is showing, but Rudolph, again, a guy who's been consistently in the year in the league as a consistent name in the NFL. He's a longtime veteran, so I could definitely see an upgrade for him, maybe up to maybe even a 92, 93, 94, something like that, as he comes to the Giants. So you see a lot of these guys I'm picking here, you know, some of them are movers, right? Marvin Jones, Corey Davis, now Kyle Rudolph. So could we potentially see a movers program that brings a lot of these guys to light? Only time will tell. another guy, and this is the dude that I think is needed just for a theme team purpose, not because they had a good year. I think he only played one game this season, but Blake Jarwin, Cowboys theme teams, he's their best tight end at an 84. Upgrade this dude, get him up to a 94, 95, 96. How do the Cowboys have any upgrades at tight end? How? Crazy. But Blake Jarwin, nonetheless, I think he should just get the upgrade just by default, kind of just being the only tight end there for the Cowboys in need of an upgrade. And last but not least, the other tight end I think who could get an upgrade, and that would be pretty welcome, is OJ Howard here for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Up and down time in the NFL so far. He was injured this year, obviously, again, but you could go ahead and throw an upgrade on him for sure, 94, 95, make that Tampa Bay Buccaneers offense a little bit more glitchy. Now that we got through the flashy dudes, let's kind of get into the trenches a little bit. Let's get a little bit grimy. Let's talk about the dudes who are leading the league in tackles and such. And the dude that jumps off the page for me right away is not Foisati Aluakun, who we will touch on, but Avery Williamson. I mean, look at this, dude. Avery Williamson led the league in combined tackles. In combined tackles. He's all over the field. This dude is leading the league in combined tackles and solo tackles, and his best guard is a 91. Now, I know linebackers don't matter. I know they suck. I know it's really hard to sell somebody on the linebacker being important in this game this year, but I mean, come on, guys. This dude led the league in tackles. Like, let's go. Zach Cunningham just got his card not too long ago. He's well-deserved as well. So the number three tackler in the NFL right now, Zach Cunningham, has a 99. Roquan, I believe, has a 99. Stop playing with Avery Williamson. Give him a 99 already, all right? Foisati Aluakun right here. Foisati Aluakun is also among the lead leaders in tackles there. As you see, he's about, I think, I would say, like, what, 12, 10? But Aluakun comes to you with 90 speed on a linebacker on his 92. So just imagine if he's a 97, 98. He's coming there at least with 94, 95, like maybe 96 speed, depending on how you get him chemmed up too with his power up. He's a pass coverage linebacker. I think out of all of them, he might be the most important one to actually get one because he has speed. He has decent size at 6'2". He's a little bit smaller, but he has speed, man. He has speed. And if that hit power gets juiced up to 94, 95, zone coverage could easily go over to 90, 92. He might be a fun card to use out there with Lurker. So Foisati Aluakun for sure. Now, a dude who doesn't have a card in the game at all here is Tyrell Adams. He's been in the league 5 years. I mean, I've been trying to look for this. T-Y-R-E-L-L. I don't see anything here. Tyrell Crosby, by the way. Tyrell Williams, should also get an upgrade from the Lions. But Tyrell Adams, nothing here. But if you go through the list here, he's also on the list for total tackles in the NFL. As you see right there, 125 tackles. This dude is sandwiched between the likes of Fred Warner, Jordan Poyer, Darius Leonard above him. This dude had a solid year right here, so we should get him an upgrade for sure on the Bills, I believe, is his team this year. So yeah, the Bills could definitely get him on the squad as a linebacker. A guy who also could use an upgrade who didn't play much this year is Devin Bush. Only 5 games under his belt this year. And as you see, he got a Ghost of Madden Future card way back when. This is his best card right now. It's 88. So 91 speed on his 88. Imagine if he gets a 95, 96 linebacker card there. That could be one of the fastest linebackers, defensive players in the game, man. Once you power him all the way up, 92 hit power too on his 88. So just imagine when you boost him up there. He could be a good card to have in your squad. Problem is he's 5'11", so he's kind of similar to Sam Mills' vein, but he's 234, a little bit thick. So you love to see that there for a linebacker. So shouts to Devin Bush. Another guy who's on the tackles list here and has no love is Alexander or AJ Johnson, whatever you want to call him here. AJ Johnson, he's right here under Jordan Poyer and Tyrell Adams there. So AJ Johnson, I mean, get him an upgrade, right? His best card's an 84 right here for the Broncos. Broncos theme team could definitely use this linebacker and boost him up a little bit. Get him up there, right? I mean, all these other linebackers are very well statted in the game. Linebackers, safeties, whatever you want to call them. A lot of these guys are very well statted in the game right now. Boost these other dudes up. They deserve it. They had one hell of a year. Pass rushing now to a guy who didn't have a hell of a year because it was kind of cut short. Von Miller. Now, Von Miller kind of gets the Saquon Barkley boost here as a big name who needs a big upgrade. 92 is the last card for Von Miller. This is through the whole progression there of the Harvest program. You could, you know, power him up, put him in the set, whatever. But the point of the argument here is that 92 is the best card for Von. He's arguably one of the best, if not the most popular defensive players in the NFL. He had a down year, obviously, due to injury. But Von Miller, I mean, the season's over. Let's go upgrade him. He's staying with the Broncos. I don't see a reason to not give him a card, maybe make him a mover's master, so to speak, and just stick him with the Broncos, similar to how they did with Dak and J.J. Watt for the free agency promo. So Von Miller here, I don't hate it. I definitely get him a 99. It's Von Miller. Let's go. Another guy here defensively. Now, he kind of had an off year compared to years past, but I will give him a shout out as Max Crosby. He's up there among the defensive pass rush leaders. He didn't have a great year like he had in 2019, but 2020 season, no slouch either. So I'm going to give a quick shout out here to Max Crosby off the edge there for the Oakland Raiders. Now, as we progress through defensive side here, we're going to touch on fumbles, interceptions, because I feel like they're kind of one and the same. When we're looking at forced fumbles here, though, you see a lot of the same names, right? I mean, you just look at Myles Garrett, Marlon Humphrey, Hassan Reddick, Yannick Ngakoue. There's a lot of guys who force a lot of fumbles, a lot of big name dudes, Chase Young, JPP. They have a lot of good cards right now, right? So we're going to take a couple of the names out of there, and we're also going to take some names here out of interceptions. Now, as you see here, some of the league leaders in interceptions already have a lot of cards, right? Justin Simmons, Harrison Smith, J.C. Jackson, Xavien Howard. So we're going to kind of do some deep cuts here. And I know we like to do some deep cuts, but the first guy we're going to talk about here in particular is Michael Ojemudia from the Denver Broncos. Michael Ojemudia. The reason why I want to talk about him for two reasons. Number one, his best card is a 68 core rookie. Fine, 68 core rookie. But this dude didn't have a bad season for Denver. He played all 16 games, four forced fumbles, which is among the league leaders. It's 15th. Six pass deflections right there. 62 total tackles from a cornerback. 6'1", 200. I think he's a dude who could probably get an upgrade here before the season ends out, before the year ends out. Hopefully next year he still plays above his head there. Still balls out because it's 6'1", 200. That's some great size there for a corner. And I like to see him do well. So shouts to Michael Ojemudia right there. Hope to say your name a little bit more in the future. Another guy who I hope to say name in the future here is Amani Hooker. Safety here for the Titans. He's somebody I thought back in the playoffs promo could get an upgrade, and they still haven't touched it. Why did I think Amani Hooker could get an upgrade? Well, it's simple. He played 16 games for the Titans this year. Now, this dude wasn't setting the world on fire, but as their safety back there, he had four interceptions, and he started three games, but he finished the season with four interceptions, had 51 combined tackles, one tackle for loss, so eight pass deflections as well. So I don't think it's going to be a dude that's in desperate need and people are crying about it, but he's a guy who's well-deserved. Amani Hooker had a solid season, so you can't neglect that either. And while you're looking here on the lead leaders, I mean, Amani Hooker's right there, you know, with the likes of other guys who have upgrades like a Minkah Fitzpatrick, a Kendall Fuller, Kenny Moore, Marcus Peters. So Amani Hooker, show him some love, EA. Another dude, Javelin Guidry here for the New York Jets, defensive back, 5'10". But only played 11 games, so I'm going to give him a little short shout out. But he has four forced fumbles on the year with 22 tackles. So a little bit of a hit stick artist there, but games probably aren't there where you want to see it if you want to boost a guy up from not even being in the game, right? Another dude on the safety secondary here is going to be Donovan Wilson. We're going to close out with three secondary dudes here. Donovan Wilson here for the Cowboys. Might not have been the Cowboys' best safety or cornerback this year, but Donovan Wilson did have a solid season. He played 14 games this year, had two picks, three pass deflections, three forced fumbles, had 3.5 sacks, 71 total tackles. That's a solid year, man. Solid year for a safety. I'll give him some credit, give him some love there for the second year dude. Had a very, very, very solid year for the Cowboys. I know he made some plays against us, in particular the Giants. Quandre Diggs here, safety for the Seattle Seahawks. His best card is a 92 overall. You already know about Quandre Diggs. He's already here in the league leaders among NFL in receptions. Five interceptions on the season there for Diggs. 5'9", though, is a little bit short, 200 pounds, but 92 has 90 speed, 86 man, 91 zone, 82 press. I could definitely see him getting an upgrade. Hopefully he gets an upgrade. That'll be dope, if not a power-up expansion of some sort. So Quandre Diggs there. And last but not least, we're going to touch on Earl Thomas just because, you know, he didn't really play it all this year and EA kind of excommunicated him from the game after his little scandal earlier in the year, which wasn't really a scandal. It was just a dude kind of enjoying his life and kind of went to a little bit crazy, I guess. So Earl Thomas here, long story short, though, doesn't have an upgrade at all this year. He only has a power up besides his 83. Could he get an upgrade at the end of the year? EA sneak a little power up expansion, give him to a 99 and there you go. Don't even talk about it. Maybe. I doubt it. I think they'll kind of just leave him there, kind of like Eric Berry last year. Never really got an upgrade, and now we see him this year, and he's a boss. So that's going to do it here for the list. That's all the guys I wanted to touch on. I know it was a longer video than we're used to, but it is what it is. It's off-season time here in Mutt, right? We're going to do a lot of recap and reflection. So that's the list. Let me know below which guys do you think should get an upgrade sometime soon. And Madden 21 Ultimate Team, appreciate y'all for stopping by. Catch you next time. Peace out.